Hey guys, welcome back once again. Today I'm coming at ya with some house flippier. I know, very surprising, isn't it? I have been addicted to this game, so I do apologize for the influx of house flipper content at the moment. But we are back at it again with the white vans. So we are going to jump straight in. I'm a busy gal. A lot of people are trying to get in contact with me. So with that being said, I might actually try and complete some of these tasks today before we go in and actually see how bad the new house I bought is. So with that being said, let's jump on in. And maybe, just maybe, we want to go with the inhabitable bunker because for some reason, it's a different color. Last week, my dear, sweet wife decided that her mum will live with us. So I determined that a perfect place for our lovely mother will be a cold metal construction deep under the ground. To keep things short, I want a place for her in the bunker. I want to place her in the bunker. Whoop. It's all for the sake of safety, of course. For mum to move in, minimal facilities are needed there. A bed, a bathroom, and a kitchen. And when I write minimal, I really mean minimal. Don't overdo it with comfort, because as I think, mum won't honour us with her presence for long. It would be nice if you add some apocalypse survival items in there because it would make easier to convince my wife that it's all for safety reasons. Signed, son-in-law who's waiting for his lovely mother to move in. I'm getting some really subtle hints that maybe he doesn't want his mother-in-law to move in. But Stiff Bicky's mate, she's moving, and okay. It looks like there might be some trash. Oh, what a nice little house though. I don't think I've cleaned one that's had a nice garden like that. Okay, by the looks of it, here we go. I could hear that before I opened it. Okay, like, I get you don't want your mother-in-law to move in, but seriously, that's just disgusting. This is nasty. There's cockroaches everywhere. Ah, that's the way that I came in. Oh, wait, no, there's two entry and exit points. Well, okay then. Let's get a cleaning, shall we? Ugh. This makes such light work of the goddamn cleaning. Okay, let's vacuum these bad boys up. Y'all are nasty? And y'all are nasty. Okay, by the looks of it, I'm gonna have to put stuff back on the shelf. This might take a hot minute. The actual thought of like prepping for doomsday is slightly terrifying. For the fact that I'm like, it doesn't matter how much you prepare, eventually you're gonna run out of supplies. And there's not much you can do about it. Okay, so that's all good. But according to here, I've still got some more trash, and I've still got dirt? But where? Where, oh, where is the dirt? And he wanted minimal, so okay, it's going to be minimal. I'm technically done. I mean, this is really, really minimal stuff in here. I feel like that's not acceptable. Okay, shower. Let's do the quick and easy one. Okay, well that one's at least done. Okay, so we need bunk beds. Maybe I'll be able to chuck that over in that corner. In equipment? Okay, well that just seems like the wrong spot to have bunk bed. Okay, bunk bed, done. Turbine power generator. Ah, turbine power generator, there we go. Wrong. Cabinet, induction cooktop, chair, and simple table. I feel like there was no fridge, but I guess that'd make sense in a apocalyptic situation. The fact that there is still trash somewhere is infuriating. I, for the life of me, cannot find the trash. Oh my god, there it is. Ugh, now I just need to clean the dirt. Let's just cover all the floor until I accidentally get it, shall I? Okay, wait. Ugh, I thought that was it for a second. Did not see that anywhere. I don't even know what I got, but let's finish this bad boy. I'm sorry, did he pay me $15,000 to do this? Oh, thank you very much, Mr. I hate my mother-in-law. Christmas chores, garage, help to clean up a big house. Okay, let's help to clean up a big house. After the death of my beloved wife, I sold our house as it brings back so many memories that I cannot cope with. I've decided to buy a new house and it requires some work. It needs cleaning and new radiators. It is too much work for me and I don't have the strength. I would like to move out of my old house as soon as possible and it is painful to live there. My two daughters will be living with me and would like their rooms painted their favorite color. Okay, Jack Rubens, let's do it quickly. I may not do the entire thing because I don't want to paint your daughter's bedrooms. Like, even the kitchen isn't too bad, but is this the same layout as the house that guy rented to students. Is that correct? Because it kind of looks like it might be. Clean the windows, everybody's favorite time. Okay, so this one needs the sleepy blue paint. So maybe I will, just maybe. Okay, that one is done. Let's paint with sleepy blue. Maybe I'll do a feature wall. I feel like feature walls are a great way to get around it because technically I am still painting it sleepy blue, but I don't have to do all the work. That's such not a nice color for a bedroom though. Like, it's just not what I picture a nice sleepy blue to look like. To me, sleepy blue, dark blue. I don't want to go to sleep in a light blue room. I think that's enough. I think a feature wall's very in at the moment and I think they'll appreciate it. It is just really sad. Why is it so satisfying? It reminds me of, there's a Mario, is it Mario Party? I'm not 100% sure, but there's a game where you gotta try and, is it Jackhammer? Like, you gotta try and follow the path and create the picture. It reminds me of that a little bit. How disgusting can I make this? Feel like I can probably do a pretty good job. Okay, let's get that gray out, shall we? Was it just straight up gray? I think it was. Beautiful. We'll deal with that. Enjoy your circus themed room. Ladies, you know what? I'm gonna mount your radiator because I do not want you to freeze to death. Okay, that is this place done enough. Okay, with that being done, let's go to our new house. I still haven't even gone for a visit. An abandoned house. How disgusting is this gonna be? Because I have this really bad feeling it's gonna be fucking manky as. But then look at that little mini map. It's gonna be manky. It's not a good sign, is it? Okay, let's get rid of all the jank first. Oh no. This is the exact same house as the other one. Okay, let's clean these bad boys. Ew, what is all that? Nasty, this is so nasty. Ugh. You're nasty. You know what, I'm gonna sell all the doors because they're disgusting. Okay, now it's window cleaning time because we all love, I can see a cobweb that I missed. God damn it. I did not see the top of these. Oh my God, I did not look up in this room at all. Nasty. And one more. Beautiful. Finito. Okay, let's mix it up a little bit. Let's see what wall tiles I can do that could actually be a little bit funky. Can I do these? How nasty are they? Actually, don't mind them. Let's mix it up a bit, shall we? I think a nice white floor tile in here would be good as well. I will need to paint the top of that window though, because that is disgusting. Light yellow. Oh, maybe. Yeah, I don't hate that. I don't mind that at all. Let's get this bathroom done, shall we? It doesn't really say how to get into that shower, so that's fine. I mean, it's a little bit tight, but we can make that work. Let's throw on a blind so nobody can sneak a peek. I mean, I wouldn't mind keeping that yellow theme just throughout the house ever so slightly. I feel like cream walls and yellow tiles here as well, just to see what happens. Ooh, a new skill point. This is what I'm talking about. I feel like it's gonna be plastering though, and I don't think I've plastered anything yet. Now in here, I'm thinking about something a little bit wild. I'm not gonna lie. I'm thinking I might even paint it yellow. I'm hoping that there's a nice yellow. Let's go walls. Paint. I did click on plaint, yep. Unless I wanna go bright peach. That could be a nice slightly. I feel like sunny orange could be really intense. Sunny yellow might be actually nice. We'll see. We'll see how intense it is. It might be a little bit too much. New skill point. What have we got? Is it painting? Ooh, three walls at the same time. 25% faster. Let's go 25% faster. I really don't hate this color as much as I thought I would have. I realize though, I have not cleaned the windows in the bedroom. Hell yeah. Okay, let's do the floors. I think something light and maybe bright. Unless I did just do the beige carpet. Let's just see. Almost seems dark, but it may not seem too dark out in these rooms. Whew. Let there be light. There we go. Okay. I think just something simple, a nice little fridge kitchen combo. I feel like maybe just a simple, minimal, single bed. Put a little bedside table, and I think we'll nearly be okay. Like, I think I just want to keep it simple in here. I'm not going to decorate too much. I probably won't be able to help myself, and I will, of course, throw in a plant. But other than that, I think everything's probably just going to be pretty simple and nothing too crazy, because I realize that I've done the same house three times pretty much, because they've just called it different things and decorated them slightly different. No radiator in the bedroom. This place is in a very warmer climate. You do not need it. It's totally fine. Okay, a nice minimalistic bed. I don't know why this doesn't come with bedding. I can't put it on there. I don't know how to do it. So that's totally fine. We're going to rock with that. I might chuck some curtains up, and then that is the bedroom done. And then we've just got to do the lounge room pretty much. And then this place can be flipped and sold, and we can move on to bigger and better things. Okay, blinds in, everything's done. Now that it's nighttime, that wall color does not look as good as it once did. So apologies, but it's too late now. Kind of feel like putting the TV over here. Let's see what I can do. Like, I think I might even just throw in one armchair and that's it. And they're going to get a rug and a table to eat their dinner on. And that is it. Let's just chuck a mirror as soon as you walk in. Mirrors are meant to make the place look bigger. So we'll go with that. Is there a trash can in this place? No. But is that going to stop us? Also, no. Maybe one more rug as we walk in, because I have no self-control and I feel like it needs it. Okay. Finito, bonito, let's sell this place. I bought it for $47,000, so if we can sell it for $55,000 at least, that'd be great. Oh, $58,000 already? Hell yeah. $64,000. You know what? I'm gonna try and negotiate another $2,000. Hey, there we go. Nice. Let's accept his offer. Okay. That is our third house flipped. Ooh, new skill point. What is it? Negotiation. Okay, let's see what other houses we can buy. We've got $124,000, so I feel like we could probably splurge ever so slightly and get a half decent house. That being said, I don't know if I want to go the one after the flood. Connoisseur's home? Maybe. This nice brick one, I don't think I'll have to do any work to the outside of that house, which would be very, very nice. House with the uninvited guests, though. I'm gonna say that's cockroaches. And it's real nasty inside. Okay, that being said, let's buy it and finish it up. Okay, house number 4 has been bought. That is good. We are progressing like an absolute maniac. If I'd known that all three of the cheaper houses were the exact same house, I would have not kept going with the cheaper houses, so I do apologize. But we have skipped through that now. We are on to bigger and better things. That being said, I'm gonna have to wrap up this episode here though. I hope you guys have enjoyed flipping some houses with me today. Thank you guys so much for coming on this flipping journey with me, and I'll see you next time. Bye!